COVID antiviral pills. Five things experts want to know more. The UK is the first country to approve two antivirals for COVID-19. Although experts see the potential, they still want to know a few more things. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. According to the journal Nature, the UK approved Merck's molnupiravir on November 4. In just over a month, the country approved two antiviral drugs against the disease, Merck's and Pfizer's paxlovid. Both antivirals were observed with excellent impact on the coronavirus, though their real-world effects aren't known at present. Will they change the global situation for real? They would be relatively cheap to manufacture. For large parts of the world that have not got good vaccine coverage, this is really a godsend, said CEO Charles Gore at Medicines Patent Pool, a UN-backed organization in Switzerland. Here are what experts want to know about these antivirals. First is the effectiveness, and so far, both the drugs could cut a good chunk in hospitalization and death rates. But full reports of clinical trials are not yet publicly released. Crucial details like age, ethnicity, health conditions, and timing are just some of the things experts want to evaluate. The second is safety, with a focus on tolerance and degree of side effects. No matter how small, a risk is a risk, and experts want to know how many doses a person can withstand for a specific period. The third is the impact on COVID-19 variants. Experts are cautious because some variants have been known to dodge immune response. Merck's and Pfizer's antivirals have different targets than vaccines. Though experts want to be sure if variants won't find a way to beat these new drugs. There's also a concern if any components may lead to unwanted viral mutations. The fourth is the chances of resistance against antivirals. Viruses that cause hepatitis C and HIV are known to resist. That's why patients tend to get a combination of antivirals. And finally, accessibility in rural areas. COVID-19 pills require a prescription, and as such, the testing rate must be high to maximize the pills. That means testing needs to be ramped up in low and middle-income nations. What do you think about these new antivirals? Do you agree with the experts? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching. Thank you.